The hills of Appalachia are part of America's legacy. The people here in Martin County, Kentucky, proudly self-sufficient. But it's hard to take care of yourself when you don't have the most basic of necessities.
So we have blue water here.
It's left Hope Workman with no other choice. Twice a week, Hope and her daughter drive up this dirt path on the side of a mountain.
This is what we go through. Get water.
20 years ago, she placed this 3.5-foot long pipe into this hillside to tap a spring, just to collect clean drinking water. Because obviously, no one drinks the water here.
Do you drink it?
Oh, no. No, there's no way that I drink it.
Gary Ball is the editor-in-chief of the local weekly paper, The Mountain Citizen. Water has been a front-page story for most of his career.
What's going on here? I mean, if the citizens, the people who live here and deal with this every day, where do they put this on their list of concerns?
In 2018, in the very place where LBJ declared war on poverty, 54 years ago, water is our number one issue. That's hard to imagine.
If you declare a war on poverty, 54 years later, you come back there and you can't even reliably get clean water, what progress have we really made?
It's like third world country here, as far as water. We've let our water system just dilapidate to the point of collapse.
You went how long without water?
At that time, it was 10 days.
To manage that, Hope has turned her pool into a makeshift reservoir, collecting rainwater for even the most basic needs.
In order to wash your clothes, in order to get water to bathe in, this is what you have to do.
Yes, I did this in 17-degree weather, and we had to take a chainsaw to drill through the ice to get to the water.
So you used the chainsaw to get through the ice and then siphoned the water with your mouth out of this hose?
Yes.
That's what it's come to?
That's what it's come to.
In fact, the American Society of Civil Engineers gives the United States drinking water infrastructure a grade of a D.
This is the water that's coming out
of my how
tap.
Does the water get so contaminated here in Martin County? It's worth looking at how we get our water. Here, it comes from the Tug Fork River, where it is then pumped into the Crum Reservoir. And from there, it makes its way to this water treatment center.
After getting treated, about 2 million gallons per day of fairly clean water then leaves this treatment facility through a cascade of pipes traveling all over the county. Problem is, those pipes are also old and cracked. More than 50% of the water leaks out before it gets to the people who need it. Even worse is what's getting into those pipes and into the water.
We reviewed the most recent EPA data, and the Martin County Water District has violated federal drinking water standards every quarter between October 2014 and September 2017. In fact, until just a few months ago, the district's nearly 10,000 customers received notices that their water had exceeded federal limits for potentially cancer-causing chemicals.
Doc, I got this thing. What am I supposed to do about that? Am I going to get cancer?
It's a very difficult question. I can't tell them that it's safe or that it isn't safe.
Dr. Lon Lafferty is the quintessential small-town doc. He's pretty sure that almost every person in this county has come to see him at some point in his clinic.
We shouldn't have to be asking in 2018 whether or not the water is causing cancer in our region. We should be to the point in 2018 in the richest country in the history of the earth that we have clean water. It shouldn't be a question.
Eastern Kentucky has some of the highest cancer rates in the country, and there's plenty of blame. Smoking, obesity. But one thing stands out to many who live there. The water.
Is it the rainwater that you're getting is better than what's coming out of your faucet?
Yeah.
On this day, Hope is filling up 3 additional pots of water from her pool.
It's not easy, but it beats not being able to flush the toilet or take a bath. I hope you see this, Mr. Trump, because I don't know who else to talk to about it. They ain't doing a damn thing.
President Trump released a $1.5 trillion plan to address all of infrastructure for the whole country. But experts estimate $1 trillion alone is needed just to meet our drinking water demands for the next 25 years.
Central Appalachia, at this point, is being left behind. Central Appalachia certainly voted for President Trump, but we always kind of take a wait-and-see kind of attitude. Time will tell.
Is water a basic human right?
I believe so.
That's not happening here.
That's not happening here.
And I'll tell you, Wolf, what's happening in Martin County is not unique. There's about 150,000 small water systems like Martin County, and they represent 72% of the EPA violations for the whole country. These are small systems, Wolf. They are rural systems, and they are ignored, Wolf.
Dr. Sanjay Gupta, thanks so much for that really, really important report. Appreciate it greatly.